Last week I demonstrated JJ's 59 set pickups in this guitar, which I call Kermit. I call it Kermit because it's a bit green. I put a little Kermit sticker on the back there. Very cute, I know. I enjoyed a little bit of criticism in the comment section of that video for playing with too much reverb and delay, which is understandable. But when you're alone, it's a very lonely pursuit, the old YouTube stuff. I like a little bit of company, and so I give it to myself with a reverb and delay, which I hardly ever use on stage. By the way, I use delay, I don't use reverb much. Anyway, I thought I should backtrack a little bit and just dial up very simple amps in the XFX 3 Turbo over here to show you what these pickups sound like through something simple and dry. And while I was doing it, of course, I created a preset with a whole heap of different amps in it called Kermit's Rig. So first of all, here are these pickups dry. Back pickup first. We're talking about a Princeton AA964. Yes, the old Princeton amp, not the Princeton reverb, right? Although I do have a very slight small spring reverb there. Two things. This is scene three from our preset, which you can see. The cabinet that I've chosen is the 1x10 Blackface Princeton, one with a 57 and another one with a ribbon mic, so it's a mixture of both microphones. And let's get these pickups, you know, out of the way first. So the back pickup. Elneko 5, about 6.2, 6.3K. Position 2. Plenty of quack. And the Princeton's, you know, it's kind of scooped as well. So I'll show you with an older amp in a moment how it sounds with something that's not as scooped. Middle pickup. Position 4. And the neck pickup. So the middle pickup is reverse wound polarity, reverse round, you know, 6K. And the neck is 6K as well, both A5s. So these are the brightest Strat pickups that JJ's do. And they're very clean and sparkly and spanky, a kind of citrusy sort of, but they're not shrill, which I love. Let's have a listen to a slightly older amp model now, in particular the 6G4 Super Amp. Which I think was a brown face amp from 1960, 61, something like that. So we'll start with a neck pickup. By the way, this is scene one in our Kermit's Rig setup, and I'm using the 2x10 Super G4, funnily enough, which is a Dynacab. And we have a dynamic one, which is like a 57 on the outside of, you know, kind of halfway between the edge and the dome, the speaker dome. Back pickup. Position 2. Middle pickup. Position four. Neck pickup. I really like that amp. There's a particular mid-range about it. If we go to scene two here, we've got the 6G12 Concert. From the same era. Slightly different sound, though. Now, if I'm not mistaken, the Concert had a harmonic tremolo. Which I've altered the phase to be 90 degrees. That gives it that stereo width. So if I back that phase off, it's nice and mono, but I do like the stereo thing going on there. So there you go. You can turn that on or off at your leisure. Scene three is the Princeton, which we've already heard. Scene four is Prince's Swim, which means I've got a compressor up the front here. And quite a lot of delay, multi-delay and plex delay. So the delay is doing a dual delay. I think I lifted that from the Gilmore lead preset. The multi-delay is on the Aurora delay, which is the pseudonym for Halo delay, which is Robert Keeley's amazing invention. G'day, Robert. So I've only got 9% mix there, but if you want to get really wet, you can flick it over to channel A and it'll be really wet. Get the idea? I always have a swim scene because it's just nice to have an ambience scene. Scene five is our Princeton AA964 with a super overdrive in front of it. So pretty simple combo, the old Boss SD1. Scene six is, I call it Zen Rote, because it's got a rotary that is controlled with the FC1 pedal. So if you don't have an expression pedal plugged into that particular hole on the back of your rig, you may want to alter it. The dirt is coming from the drive section up here in the front, and it is the good old Zen drive. Hello, Alphonse Hermida. Of course, you can turn that drive off if you want it, just keep it clean. Yeah. I like the little bit of dirt that the drive gives us. Scene 7 is the AA964 Princeton with a crunch box and a little bit of that multi-delay halo in there. And then because I could, I've put a Dave scene in at scene number 8, which is the super overdrive, which is the high watt 103 jumped, basically the same settings from the Gilmore lead preset, and the 4x12 high watt cab mix with the dual delay and the medium room reverb. So it's basically the Gilmore lead preset, just rewritten for this preset, for this scene, this preset, scene 8. So you can go from, you know, something like Princeton through to of course, all of the other satellite effects are in there as well. So chorus, compression if you want it, the multi-delay, all sorts of fun stuff. So there you go, that's Kermit's rig, and that's what these pickups sound like through pretty old school Fender style combos. They're great pickups. I'm enjoying them. This guitar is a Music Craft neck and a Warmoth body, if I'm not mistaken, strapped together by my friend Lindsay Hart. G'day, Lindsay. That's all. Enjoy the preset. It's running on firmware 26.02 beta, which is what you will need or later to run it on your XFX 3. I'm not sure if it'll load into the FM9 yet. Probably not, but you can try it. And by the time you see this video, there may already be a later version of the firmware released, given Fractal Audio's unbelievable progressive service to their customers. And I thank you, Cliff, Matt, and all the team at Fractal. See you soon.